Hello, Ringo students. My name is Ali Arishuni. I went to school at Harvard College, and I studied human developmental and regenerative biology. Yeah, so Obama is a very popular figure internationally, but in his early years and in his middle years, he faced a lot of trouble in the United States with gaining high approval ratings. And there are a lot of reasons for that. My opinion is that the first and foremost reason is that he's a very unconventional presidential candidate, right? He's the first black president we've ever had in the United States. And because of that, because he is the first of a kind in a structure that's existed for hundreds of years, people are very, very critical of everything that Obama does. So it doesn't matter what he's doing or why he's doing it. There will always inherently be people who are incredibly critical of someone who's new to a field. There's not someone who's new to a field, because Obama is definitely not new to the presidency with respect to his experiences as a senator and his incredible depth of knowledge and experience. But the idea of having a black president in the first place, and what we're seeing today is that racism is very prevalent in the United States of America. It's there. And to say that it's not is, I think, contributing a lot to the problems that the United States is facing. Because let's face it, to elect someone like Donald Trump to the presidency, there has to be a very strong sentiment against minorities in the United States because of Donald Trump's rhetoric towards minorities. And so in line with that, when President Obama took the helm, a lot of people were already inherently more critical of him right when he was coming into office because he was an unconventional candidate. And the second thing is that a lot of people in the United States forget to look at the whole picture, right? Obama is very much a whole picture kind of person. When he's making decisions, he's focusing on the whole picture. How is this going to affect the entire country and the global stage? Whereas people in the United States will typically only care about one or two issues, and if the candidate does not align with those one or two issues, they automatically disapprove. And I can give you examples of this. Some people are against abortion in the United States or for abortion in the United States. And they're so for abortion, or they're so against abortion, or not abortion, but the right to choose whether or not you want to have abortion. They can be so for or so against it that it doesn't matter what other issues the president is talking about, they only focus on that issue. And that can be very problematic, because even though the president is like the best overall, he's the best whole candidate we have, people will still elect the other candidate because of those minutiae, like the smaller issues, without looking at the whole picture. So I think that's partially why, even though Obama is, in my opinion, such a phenomenal president, incredibly intelligent and incredibly good speaker, very culturally sensitive to cultures from around the world, even though Obama's all of those things, his approval ratings remained low during his presidency because of the aforementioned things, right? But another fun fact is that after Donald Trump was elected, during the electoral campaign, President Obama's ratings actually skyrocketed, and they were some of the highest in United States history. So that's the other half of the experience, I would say.